First up, Sydney being hit by hundreds of lightning strikes as a storm rolls in, the second in as many days.
The city's still recovering after 7,500 bolts smashed the city over 3 hours, even blasting a hole into the main runway of Sydney Airport, causing delays and cancellations.
At the Botanic Gardens, four people seeking shelter under a fig tree were knocked unconscious for up to a minute after it was also struck.
All four patients were transported urgently to the trauma centre at Royal Prince Alfred and St Vincent's Hospital. Our four patients are age ranging from 19 to 36, two male patients and two female patients, suffering from burns in their backs and limbs, and also presenting with cardiac symptoms.
We'll have an update from our reporter live in the next 30 minutes.
Queensland could have a new top cop within days after the state's Police Commissioner Katarina Carroll revealed she may not continue.
Today's Andrea Crothers is following that story for us. Andrea, pressure has been growing for her to resign.
Yeah, good morning, guys. We have been reporting now for weeks that there's been pressure over Queensland's top cop. Police unrest over staff shortages, as well as dealing with a number of issues across the community, like escalating domestic violence issues and the youth crime crisis. Now, Katarina Carroll confirming she may not continue in the top job. Her contract is due for renewal come July, telling Nine News last night that those conversations will start soon. I may not ask for an extension to my contract, adding, I'm seriously considering my options and one is not asking for an extension. Now, the police union, they had been backing her in. They're not commenting on the matter today. The police minister, though, he is saying if she does seek an extension to that contract, he would be supportive of that, guys.
Andrew, thank you.
The career of Kangaroos midfielder Taran Thomas is hanging in the balance this morning after Nine News exclusively revealed he'll be suspended for 18 weeks by the AFL. Today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn is at North Melbourne HQ. Chris, Thomas has been accused of domestic violence.
Brooke, these are new allegations of domestic violence that emerged last month. As a result, Taran Thomas was summoned to AFL House and an investigation was launched. As a result of that investigation, Nine News exclusively revealed that the 23-year-old has been hit with a monster 18-week ban. That is the largest in recent memory and could spell the end of his AFL career. He certainly does have a long rap sheet, however, and he has been given numerous chances here at North Melbourne. In February last year, he was suspended after making serious and confronting threats against a woman. In July, he escaped conviction after threatening to distribute an intimate image of a woman. His teammates here at Arden Street yesterday, however, were not keen to talk.
You're disappointed about Taran Thomas's suspension, mate?
Oh, I can't comment on anything at the moment.
Are you disappointed to hear about the fact that Taran's possibly been suspended, mate?
I haven't spoken to Dawn, so, just chat to the media manager.
The official line from the AFL is that their investigation by the Integrity Unit is continuing. However, it is believed that that 18-week ban could be confirmed as soon as today. Brooke.
Okay, thanks, Chris. New this morning, a man has been charged over an alleged assault of a supermarket employee in Western Sydney. The 25-year-old is alleged to have attempted to leave without paying for items at the Blacktown store before allegedly pushing the 64-year-old worker, who remains in a critical condition after hitting his head on the floor. The man was refused bail and will appear in court today. Eight protesters have been charged after a lengthy rooftop standoff lasting more than 12 hours in Melbourne's east. Let's go live to Today Melbourne reporter Isabella Staszkowski. Isa, what charges are they facing?
Brooke, they're all facing charges of criminal damage, trespass and being disguised with unlawful intent. This group is aged between 26 and 72 and yesterday, as you say, they were involved in quite a standoff. It was before 6 a.m. that it is alleged they went onto the roof of that building and then refused to come down. By the afternoon, they did ask officers for help and a cherry picker was organised to get them off the roof of that building safely. Here is how some of yesterday unfolded.
Rosebank is the sole global supplier of a part for the F-35 Stryker jets used by Israel.
That it's unsafe on the roof. There are areas that contain asbestos. The roof is prone to them falling through it.
Brooke, they will all be facing the Ringwood Magistrates Court. It's understood that that will be in July.
Okay, thanks, Izza. Nine News can reveal the only survivor of the alleged toxic mushroom meal served by Aaron Patterson has provided homicide detectives with a formal statement. It comes after the 70-year-old pastor made an emotional first address to the Corrumburra Baptist Church since the incident. Sydney rail commuters and workers could potentially be risking their health at some of the city's deep underground stations. Alarming results on the deepest stations show levels over double the safe daily limits for particle pollution, the worst being Central, that's according to the Sydney Morning Herald. Star Entertainment Group is back in the spotlight with the New South Wales regulator launching an independent review to see if it's suitable to be holding a licence. The announcement blindsiding executives, the move to see if the group has fixed its problem-plagued Star Casino after a 2022 inquiry uncovered crime links, money laundering and fraud. Company shares are now at a trading halt. Do a live toad, a slug, bird nest and holy water have in common? Well, these are all items found in Carl's dressing room. No. These are all items that have been seized at Australia's international airports last year. They're among 400,000 items stopped by biosecurity officers, preventing the infestation of foreign pests or diseases to our country. I don't know why they had to include holy water in that.
Well, one has to repent during Lent. You've got to have it
down the alcohol.
Let's take a look at our fly round forecast for you this morning on this Tuesday and check your temperatures. Starting in Queensland, the Sunshine State not looking so sunny still. Showers around for Cairns, a top of 32 degrees. 31 the high on the way for Townsville and Mackay. 34 for Mount Isa, Longreach, 39 degrees. Possible showers around for Gladstone, 31 degrees, a shower or two for the sunny coast and also a bit of a wet one for the Goldie as well. New South Wales, Dubbo mostly sunny, 31 degrees. Storm action for Newcastle, 27. Orange, possible shower and 24. Gosford, storm action for you, the same for Wollongong, 24 degrees. Canberra, a shower or two developing and 26 today. Victoria and Tassie, let's check in on you. Becoming cloudy, 35 degrees for Mildura, 32 and mostly sunny for Bendigo. Ballarat, partly cloudy and 30. Launceston, a shower or two and 26 degrees. Strawn, a possible shower developing and 23. South Australia, Mount Gambier, cloudy and 28, 29 and cloud clearing for Port Lincoln, 27 degrees for Ceduna and Coober Pedy, mostly sunny today and 41 degrees. Let's take a look at those hot temps for WA this morning. Partly cloudy and 35 for Albany, 44 ahead for Kalgoorlie, 39 for Geraldton and also for Port Hedland, 36 degrees ahead for Broome and the Northern Territory. Darwin showers 32 degrees and Alice Springs partly cloudy today and a top of 39.